Moving on to the next session, Bankura is waiting for the next lecture. Let me introduce Mrs. Vishwakala, Senior Manager, Rajahmundry Main Branch, Canara Bank, erstwhile Syndicate Bank. Joined as Probationary Officer in the year 2008, in her banking career of over 12 years, her strong conviction is that loans given to women are regular and prompt in payment. As branch head, she has extended support to women entrepreneurs subject to bank norms. She has given 71 loans worth 187 lakhs to MSME sector. She conducted awareness programs in and around Hyderabad, Kakinada and Rajahmundry for MSME loans and especially for women entrepreneurs. Her priority always remained women, be it education loan or MSME loan. The gratitude which was shown by the beneficiaries cannot be described. It can only be heartfelt. She aspired to become a scientist. Her father persuaded her to join banking industry as that is the way to help the needy in all possible ways. She performs her job with a lot of dedication and made her father proud of his persuasion. Though we missed a scientist, AP has got a very good banker who cares for the needy, women in particular. Madam, we welcome you to this program and request you to enlighten us about the Stand Up India scheme and its modalities. Vishwakala garu.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for the introduction also. A very good afternoon to all. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. And before that, I want to bring the points which a person should take care while coming for a loan. I'll take this down. First of all, this is Stand Up India. So Stand Up India is a perfect platform for SCST and women beneficiaries. This is a loan scheme wherein we consider loans from rupees 10 lakhs to 100 lakhs. So wherever a woman is interested in establishing an entrepreneur or enterprise or whatever business she wants to establish, she can come to a bank and she can enroll for the Stand Up India and she can avail that loan. So I want to give you the things which they have to keep in mind while going for a bank loan. So what we bankers see, so whenever you approach a bank for a loan, we first see your confidence level. So don't lose that confidence level. Always keep that in your mind. So first thing, what we from our Canara Bank, what we say is, we have given many loans to women beneficiaries. And we have been on top 10 bankers where we have extended loans to the Stand Up India scheme all over India. So what we have, I want to make these youngsters who are the future entrepreneurs to keep in their mind is the following things. First one, choose a project. So choose a project in such a way that you have less competition and where you can shine. So what things which suit you and what things are in the, are to be in this present market. So that you have to keep in your mind. So after selecting your project, what you have to do is prepare a project report. You can see different projects in Google. You can have different projects, how they are prepared. With that, after analyzing a 10 to 15 projects, you can prepare your own project. Or else you have many people who guide. And even Stand Up India portal itself guides you in preparing a project. So you can prepare your project. After preparing your project report, see how you can make repayments, how you can make profits of that, like that. So after taking that, now you're ready with your project. Take your KYC documents, that is your Aadhaar card and PAN card, and your residence proof, other than this, like voter ID cards or your passport, whatever it may be. So take two copies of that and take all the project report also two copies. Keep it with you. And now next step is whenever you go to a bank, we take CIBIL report. CIBIL report shows your credit track. That is how many loans you have taken, how you have repaid the loans, and whether you have any default in making the repayments. So that you, we bankers will take into perspective. So what you have to do is CIBIL provides you CIBIL report when you approach them. not only to the bankers, even an individual can apply for their CIBIL report. So in order to increase your confidence level, you just go to the CIBIL website and take your Aadhaar card Xerox and PAN card Xerox, and then apply for a CIBIL report for yourself. Get your CIBIL report and get your CIBIL score, keep it with you. Next thing is, after seeing your CIBIL report, you will get some confidence level. Now, rehearse your project, because when we are listening to your project report, you must be in a position to convince us. So your project should be outstanding. The way you present should be outstanding. So prepare well. Prepare well how you can convince us. So rehearse the project and then at home, and then give a rehearse to your people at home. And then once you're confident, select a bank. So that also you have to see. There are people who give, women, being a woman entrepreneur, I tell about myself. I always encourage women entrepreneurs. I always encourage whoever, that may be a girl child for education loan, or that may be a business for business also. I support every woman, every girl child. So select those people, women branches, wherever are there, select that brand that will be beneficial for us. So after preparing everything, after preparing every groundwork, apply for Stand Up India, select your bank, and then go for that bank. See the bank situation there, go to the branch head and tell him that I have applied through Stand Up India and I'm here just to establish a new project here, and I want to start my project with your bank. So we will listen to you. We will listen to your project. Once we are convinced with your project, we will ask for your KYC as you are ready with that. I told you beforehand, keep every document two sets ready with you. And then as soon as we take out a CIBIL report, we tell that, okay, your project is good. We are satisfied with your project. We'll go ahead. So at that time, again, you should not stop, because we ask for everything, all the type of permissions, registrations, and all. So these things you will get from our MSME application. We have in our website, Canara Bank website, our MSME application. In that, there will be a checklist. Take that checklist before itself. After preparing your project report, according to the checklist, prepare everything, just like your record making. The way you prepare in your exams, just like that. This is an exam which you have to pass. So prepare everything according to that checklist order. You prepare everything and paste it in your file. And this is just to not to delay your project, because many people will be there. They'll be complaining that banks, they are making us come around every time, and they are asking each and every document at a time. They are not telling us at a time to bring all the documents. They are making us move 1 month, 2 months like that. So that should not be the case. So what I suggest you is, take the application. You have a checklist there neatly. All the 31 documents which you require, you will have that. And prepare according to that and get your application and that you get your folder. Once we ask you what are the permissions and all, you should be confident there. And wherever we ask permission, you have to just take it out. Yes, ma'am, I have a permission. If I ask you registration certificate, yes, ma'am, I have a registration certificate. Like that, you should give all the documents which we ask. So this will reduce the time where the sanction time will be there. So that turnover time will be there. That will be reduced. So that we can process your loan application fastly. So in this way, prepare yourself so that at any time, whatever we ask, everything will be there with you. So once it is done, once we are satisfied with your project report, we will say that, okay, you're welcome. We will be going with your project. So then we have two options. You can have term loan and a term loan plus working capital. So term loan, it is to establish a factory or to purchase machinery and all. So that term loan will have a repayment period of 7 years. 7 years is 84 months. So per month EMI will be there. Now it's a new, it's a new enterprise. So you need some time to establish. So for that also we'll give you time. It will be ranging up to 18 months. So up to 18 months, we'll give you time so that you will have a breathing time, because you have to establish it. You have to start, You have to establish the unit, then you have to go for the employees, and then you have to start. In the beginning, you will incur some loss, and then step by step, you will be gaining your profits. So we'll give you some time, but maximum period will be 7 years. And then rate of interest is very, very reasonable here. It is 8.65% in our bank. And based on your CIBIL, if it is very good score, then the rate of interest will further decrease. And women beneficiaries will always enjoy 0.50% of interest. So that is a benefit which we give. So rate of interest is very, very small and reasonable. So with this, it will be benefit for you to go into a loan. Okay. And then after you go for your term loan or working capital and all, composite loan, then the thing is security. We always ask for security. So at this time, if you have property and all, and if your home, if your parents are supporting, okay, you will give. If not, if a young entrepreneur without any security, he wants to shine, that also we have an option in the Stand Up India in collaboration with this CGTMSC. So CGTMSC norms, as the same as CGTMSC, Stand Up India is also providing security here. So the thing is, you have to pay yearly fees. The yearly fees will be there. Every year you have to pay annual guarantee fee. With that, we'll not insist you for collateral security like property, building or fixed deposit or like that. So this is a benefit for our young women entrepreneurs, because in some cases, we see that family supports women. But in many cases, women are not supported by family when they want to establish a business. They say that business is not a thing which you have to do. So in that case, when we don't get support from family, we can go ahead with Stand Up India. Stand Up India is a very good place, very good platform for women entrepreneurs. Okay. So I say that all the young entrepreneurs, all the MBA students or whatever young entrepreneurs are over there, I suggest them that go for Stand Up India. Because through Stand Up India, if you go to a bank, we don't have a chance to reject you. So it's better to go through this app. And even Stand Up India, I have seen through the website, it is providing a lot for you. It is giving you training. It is giving you the different scopes for business and all. So it is teaching you also, giving you classes also. So it is a very good platform for you. So through Stand Up India, if you come, we are also there. We also have targets for Stand Up India. So definitely you will be chosen. So that's why go for that. And now coming to examples for these young entrepreneurs also. You may think that once we have started this, we'll be in a loan or we will be in a debt. But once you start, keep your everything in that business so that you will shine in that and make your loan debt free. Make yourself debt free. Like we have many people here in Rajahmundry, in Hyderabad also, I have extended to many people there. And to be frank, I have seen that the loans which I have extended in the MSME sector, women entrepreneurs, they were promptly repaying that. And even some of them were nominated also for the programs conducted in Hyderabad. So what I say is, we women repay all the loans promptly and we take it to our heart also. We don't skip also. I have never seen a woman entrepreneur skipping an EMI. Beforehand also, they used to keep the EMI. They used to feel very happy on seeing me also. Madam, you are the first manager whom we have seen extending loans to women entrepreneurs like this. I told that we are the people who repay the loans promptly. That's why I like women entrepreneurs only. So that's the thing. Now I'll tell you few examples of women entrepreneurs who have been excellent in their this thing from our bank especially. So from our Rajahmundry, Srimati Nallamalli Sridevi is there. She's a very good entrepreneur. I have been very much impressed by her also. She is running Greenleaf Solutions. So at the time when she has approached our bank, she has started that enterprise. And when I went to that unit, I was really surprised. She was really doing awesome. The thing is, she is doing herbal products manufacture, and all the products have been excellent. So when she has applied for loan, she was almost, we have extended up to 70 lakhs to her covered under CGTMSC. She has promptly repaid that, and now all the loans she has repaid them, and she is debt free now. That is the case. It's almost 2017 she has availed the loans, and almost in a span of 4 to 5 years she has earned it and she has cleared all the loans, and now she has given employment to many people, and she has she is a role model to many people also here. I have seen her. And then her daughter Srimati Priyaha Chandralekha, she is also another young entrepreneur, and even I am very much impressed with her also. She is running Priya's Trends, artificial jewelry manufacturing unit, and she is also doing very well. And really, this is all due from her mother. She has inherited, and both of them are doing very well. See, we have extended to Priya's Trends also an amount of 25 lakhs loan, and she is repaying it very promptly. Never she has defaulted any of the EMIs. Such a prompt payment. And then we have even Kisan Mart. Kisan Mart is unit which is a unique unit in Rajahmundry, which supplies agriculture implements, which imports agriculture implements from foreign, and to support the agriculture farmers in and around East Godavari district. And that too, she is a lady, Akula Sirisha, who is running that unit. We have extended rupees 100 lakhs, 1 crore rupees to her. Really very good, very nice lady. She is also running very nicely. And just because to improve that unit, she has availed this working capital unit. Otherwise, she did not require the support also. But she is a woman entrepreneur. After seeing her, even I feel proud. Next is Crazy Foods. That is also one of the units here. Crazy Foods is a franchisee of Sweet Magic. Sweet Magic, I think many people heard of there, because basically the students here are from Vijayawada. They know about Sweet Magic. So this Crazy Foods is a franchisee of Sweet Magic. They have taken franchise and they are running it very successfully. They have started with one unit. Now they are running 3 units in Rajahmundry. That too, women entrepreneur Ummit Sridevi. So I feel very proud after seeing these people. And that too, when these people bring any proposal to bank, they come with like just like fully armed soldier. Everything, whatever we ask. See, if some people will be there, just they walk in into bank and they just ask, I need a loan, MSME loan under Mudra Yojana, under this thing, that thing. When we ask them, bring your Aadhaar card, he'll go again. He'll bring Aadhaar card. When we ask them your project report, he will go again, project report. And then when we ask everything like that, but these. What, that is what we require from you. What I say is, whatever bank you approach, be confident in explaining your project and explaining how you're going to market your products, how you're going to repay the loan, and the way you're going to establish or everything there. So we should be confident in you. We should be immediately, I mean, after studying you, actually our duty is that we study the people. How you're going to, whatever you tell us, we listen everything. With that, we analyze whether you are genuine, whether you are just, you want to establish it really or not, or you want to. We see that. So the thing is, I want you all to prepare yourself first. Rehearse yourself. Before presenting, you should be just like an exam. It's your final exam. So you should come out with flying colors. So this is what the thing which I want to get, because Stand Up India, everyone has explained you. I just wanted to explain you the way we bankers see you, the way you have to approach a banker, and the way you have to apply for a loan. Okay, so please keep all these things in your mind whenever you are going for a loan. Okay, so all the best for all the women entrepreneurs over there. And thank you very much, madam, for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.